Hello, Steph. How are
Hello,
you? Nice to
Greg.
see
Good
you.
to
You
see
guys
you
might remember
again.
Steph. She's been on the show singing before.
Yes, I
Today we're here
have.
to talk about real estate because you're also a real estate agent.
Yes, I am.
Keller Williams, one of the bigger real estate firms in the valley,
and
and
growing.
selling houses, aren't you guys?
Yes. Lots going on in the market today. And today I have something for both sellers and buyers.
Okay. So is it a seller's market or a buyer's market?
Wow, I would have to say sellers. The prices kind of keep rising, so they have a little bit more of an advantage there.
How long have you been selling real estate?
4 years.
Now, 4 years ago, let me back it up. Real estate wasn't the greatest time 4 years ago to get into. Probably not a lot going on. Was it a good time to get in?
Well, when I first got my license, it was a big career change for me. And then, of course,
what did you do before?
I worked as running a chiropractic office for
okay.
years and years.
Okay.
But anyway, getting into the market, people were like, why would you go into real estate? Honestly, with short sales, they had just really started to take hold and everything. And so I decided, well, you know, I might as well be a short sale specialist since that's what was happening. People said, no, you can't do that. It'll never work. And I got different credentials for that. And that's what I started with. And it was fine for me. I didn't know any better, you know. Realtors that had been in the market for years.
Yeah, they didn't want to mess with them.
Right. And they were a lot of work.
A lot of work and a little less money, probably, right?
Money, really, it's not the money. The commission turned out to be okay. It was the risk. Because literally, you could have a short sale, and I could be working on it for months and months, and then the bank could take it,
go
into foreclosure, people would refinance, any number of things. So, I mean, seriously, losing a deal after you put a lot of work into
it wasn't uncommon. But when it did go through, everything was good.
I think you're going to lose deals. Those are probably some good reasons to lose them for. Probably something out of your control, right?
Yes.
So, did you learn a lot going through that, though?
I learned a lot. Well, I think I learned how to really work as a realtor. I mean, you're not going to start in a market like that and really not understand how to market, how to go after business, how to make yourself something that somebody wants to call on.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I think that the people that didn't want to put the effort in probably are not in real estate. And now, gosh, with things so much better.
4 or 5 years ago, I'd look at the schedule and I'd look on there and they'd say, I'd go, oh, a realtor. Oh, no. It'd be
bad
like
news.
The rain cloud came over the studio, you know. Hey, how's it going? Oh, gosh, not so good.
Well, but you know, a lot of good has happened, honestly, to see the market turn around. People are much more positive. They're excited. You know, banks began to lend again, which was really critical because if you couldn't get a loan, how are you going
right.
to buy or sell a house?
Right.
So all of those things, I've watched those change around. And then now, you know, we've got people that literally when they call you and they want to move, it's like, well, I just saw a house that I like better, or we want to get something bigger or smaller. And it's not just distress that's getting them to sell.
So are the housing prices in Fresno really creeping up?
Yes.
Are they creeping up consistently?
Consistently. You know, especially over this last couple of years. But I think 2 years ago, people were like, are we at the bottom? You know, so there was a little bit of tendency to not want to jump in and make a purchase. But honestly, nowadays, I think pretty much people that know that if they were going to buy at the bottom, they needed to have started already now
right.
because things have just taken off.
But with the rates as low as they are,
yes.
You still buy a lot of houses.
Well, rates and programs, and I'm not an expert when it comes to lending, but there are so many different things out there to really put people into homes. And so I think that probably the fear factor being gone is so much more fun. I mean, this is way more fun to do as far
okay.
as
okay.
as far as
now,
real estate goes.
You said you brought two houses today, one for a buyer's
well,
and one for the sellers.
Well, here's what I did. I have one series of pictures, and I wanted to talk about preparing ahead of time so you actually get the money that you want. And really, my subject is paint. Okay, so that's for my sellers. And then for buyers, I have kind of an exciting group of homes coming up that nobody knows about, and I'm just going to
mention
it.
Okay, so you want to talk about staging your house now, get it
yes.
ready for sale?
Yeah, one of the things that I do, because I love to paint, literally, I'm constantly painting things. And so when I have a seller that I look at their home, most of them call me anymore, and they want to know what can we do ahead of time, because they've watched the HGTV. They understand
right.
that in order to gain value, they really do need to do something. You're not just going to throw your house on the market. It's not that kind of a seller's market. So what I brought, I wanted to just show the drama that just a little bit of paint and flooring can bring.
Okay.
And so I have a home that I had. Now, these pictures are cleared out pictures, but literally before I listed this home, there was so much stuff in this house that you couldn't even hardly walk through it. So once we cleared it out, we ended up with pink carpet and white walls, and then came in and just, the only thing I have going on here is carpet in the room, and then we painted. So those are the exact same space, and it's not a particularly unusual house. But when we started bringing people in to purchase it the second time, of course, people loved the different colors.
So we put white walls,
white
pink
walls.
Carpet,
yes,
to dark carpet,
yes,
and
to
green
a brownish
walls.
Carpet to green, and then the chocolate inset and all, and then you just put a little bit of furniture. And all the furniture in this house was purchased secondhand. There was nothing brand new. So
what was the cost of that room to change it over?
Well, I can't give you the actual cost simply because they painted themselves, okay? But the paint, you know, if you go to Home Depot, I'm a big believer in Behr paint. I think they have a great product there. Mm-hmm. And really, to get it up on the walls nowadays with the primer and the base and all, and people are more brave. They'll actually go ahead. So what I did was I just picked out the colors. And I said, you need to put this here and that there. And then they got it all up, and they did a beautiful job, and then they brought in the flooring. So.
Wow. Okay, is this the same house?
The same house. This
okay,
is the next room
the
over.
Room.
This is the living room, kind of the family room area. And so you can see we put in new flooring and then basically just secondhand furniture that was really nice, and then the wall treatment on top, and just a plain beige color there.
Now, when you say new flooring in there, was it new carpet?
Well, in that particular picture...
Can we go back to that one, Billy?
Because let's go back, because it's an interesting... You know, this is a great product. That actually looks like wood, if you can go along, but it's not. It's tiled. That's the new tile that you purchased and lay down like wood.
It looks like wood, but it's tiled.
Yeah, and I will tell you, anybody that goes and looks at it, they say, this is the most beautiful wood floor, and it's
very
difficult to take. And it
lays over the...
They took the laminate up, so it's straight down on the concrete, and they just laid it like tile. It's beautiful.
But it looked like it was wood floor before.
Yes, they had laminate. What they had was a wood flooring, that floor on one side, and then tile on the other.
Okay, so my question is, underneath that wood floor, was it slab underneath that, or was it raised wood floors?
No. No, there's
it was
no. This
slab
is a
underneath
newer
that
home.
They had laid a wood product over.
Yes, and we tore that up because there was some bubbling.
Right.
It, so.
Okay, and then the tile lays flat
they just
right
laid
down
it straight
on that
onto
pretty
the
easy
concrete.
At that point.
So huge difference.
Okay, this is
off the front door, looking at the hallway. That's looking into the kitchen, and this is kind of a fun picture because literally all it is a couple of colors of paint, and then the items that they have for furniture are things that we picked up. That's just a hutch, and so we painted it out with the dramatic blue, and it was
right.
cheap. I mean, $35, you know, and it puts nice features
awesome.
Into the house.
Awesome.
So.
Are you a big yard saler?
I'm a huge Craigslister.
Oh.
Now, remember, I do props for our music videos.
Right.
So I'm constantly out looking for props or looking for things for people's homes or whatever. So we've done some big, big projects off of Craigslist. It's great. And then estate sales.
Uh-oh,
okay,
here's
this
a
is
kitchen.
The kitchen. Now look, in this particular kitchen, same kitchen, we had that wood floor
Don't
that we
to the
brought
picture
in.
Too fast, Billy, because this one's pretty dramatic.
It right is here. Very dramatic. You can see that there's tile on the back side, there's wood on the front side, and then tons of just boring oak cabinets.
Right.
So we brought in Annie Sloan's paint, chalk paint, and I have three different tones that go on the top. We painted the center island, and then we've got the wood flooring, and
so,
it just doesn't even look like the
so
same
you,
kitchen.
So you took that Annie Sloan, come on, the Annie Sloan chalk paint and went right over the...
Right
go
over.
Go ahead and come back, Billy.
The beauty of the Annie Sloan paint, chalk paint, is that all we did was rub down with an alcohol.
Uh-huh.
To make sure that
so you lightened it up with an alcohol?
Just to make sure that no grease is going to stop us from getting that paint to adhere, and then basically just painted
so
it straight on.
Did you have to scuff up the
nope.
It went right over the... Because there's
right
a little bit of lacquer on that,
there's
right?
There's lacquer, but what happens is when you take the alcohol, if they'll just break
it lightens
the
it,
oil...
It loosens it up
yes,
a little.
Yes, it'll just break up the oil a little bit, and then you just paint it straight on. It's great stuff.
Did you rub it on or paint it on?
We painted it on, and there's a couple things you do. You paint it on. Then you take a little, and I told them exactly what to do, and they did it. And then they take a little bit of steel wool, and we distressed back a little
right.
bit. So we took off, and then we use black wax. And they hand wipe on all the
right.
wax and wipe it off, and it's done. It's a little bit of work, but it's beautiful.
And it keeps it easy to wipe down after that with the wax?
Yeah, I mean, you're not going to go scrubbing on it, but even if you do, you just reapply wax.
Right.
I mean, if you have something that kind of starts to rub off, you just reapply, and you're good to go.
Pretty smart, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, so, ooh, a bathroom.
Okay, here's a bathroom.
Look at this bathroom. How blah is that?
It's real basic, boring, and all we did was paint out the, and if you probably can't tell, but the tile in here was in perfect condition, and it's pinkish. And so instead of removing all of that tile, we actually left the pink tile.
Right.
And we left the pink in the bathtub area. And we just went with pink and dark gray and beige. And so we painted out with chalk cabinet the cabinets, painted some walls, put some other fixtures in there, and
now,
it's beautiful.
That couldn't have cost that much to do that bathroom.
The biggest expense we had, you know how you have those really cheap mirrors that are on the wall and they're like glued on the wall and they're so horrible? So we pried those off. But I think I went down to Home Goods and bought two beautiful, thick, framed mirrors. So those might have been $125 between the two of them. But outside of that, it was just the paint, you know, the bathroom thing that goes across the bathtub,
bar.
And some carpet, little rugs and things, and a piece of art. And it looks amazing.
You did all that work to that house. How long did it sell after you did the work?
First day on the market.
First day on the market.
Yeah.
How long had it been on the market before?
Well, before that, I think, I can't remember how many months, probably 6 months, 7 months. And people walk into a very boring, plain house like that, and that's on the northeast side of town.
Oh, I can tell.
So you've got good competition, you know, and it's like you need to have something that looks beautiful. In my opinion.
I bet those people didn't want to move after you did the work, too.
Well, we did the same to their new house.
Oh, okay. Now, you had some other ones you were going to show?
Well, it's not about showing pictures. What I wanted to say is that I have a client that happens to be a friend of mine that I have five rental properties and a huge house right up on Copper and Maple that are just going to be coming on the market that nobody knows about, and there's renters in each one of those homes, all in the Buchanan area, some on the Clovis side.
So you're only asking someone to buy six houses.
Well, if anybody needs a house, let me tell you, they have renters in them already. So if there's an investor looking, they're beautiful homes.
Can you claim those renters when you're applying for the home, because those are already in?
Well, the ideal circumstance, they are ready to move. None of them know about this, okay? So would they potentially would they want to stay in their homes? Absolutely. So if my seller could find somebody that would want to purchase them and leave those renters in, she just wants to move. They're moving out of the area. So... So anyway, just
who doesn't want to be a landlord?
Hey, these are beautiful homes, so you know the value already is, you know, they're by Buchanan. Right. How can you go wrong?
Okay, Steph Stolberg, thank you very much.
Thanks,
for coming.
Thanks, Jack. I
always good to see
here.
You. If people want to get a hold of you, what's the number over at Keller Williams?
My cell phone.
Okay.
It's 213-7998.
Okay.
Everybody,
you do me a favor
number.
Now, okay?
What?
Don't you take any collect phone calls.
All right. Don't worry.
Hey, we're going to take a quick commercial break. You guys stick around. We'll be right back.